candidates who join us. Of course, you probably heard him already, but Bo Dietl is somewhere behind
no,
me.
Hey. Oh,
my mother's born in Sicily.
We're also joined by Comptroller candidate Michael Faulkner. By a host of city council candidates from Brooklyn, including Steve Saperstein, Liam McCabe, and Lucretia Potter.
Yeah.
If I forgot anyone, I apologize. Nancy Tom. And Nancy Tom, thank you very much for calling, for showing up. Appreciate it. I want to call, actually, next, she just shouted out, as she always does when it comes to Italian-American culture, the former president of the State Conference of Italian-American Legislators, Senator Diane Savino.
Yay!
Thank you. Joe Borelli said, I am the former president of the Italian American Legislators. And the New York State Legislature, we have more members that come from an Italian American background than any other ethnicity combined. Italians are everywhere in this state, from the North Country to the South Bronx, from the East End to the West Side, from Tonawanda to Tottenville. There is not a community in New York State that does not have an Italian American presence. And let's think back to how that happened. More than almost 160 years ago, Italians left their home with little in their pocket, almost nothing in their bags, and they made their way to America, suffering the passage first, the indignities of our immigration system, which were far more brutal then than they are now. If you manage to get to Ellis Island, if you manage to find a place here in New York City, you encountered rampant discrimination. Italian immigrants were not welcome, not by anybody. They fought their way in and they became part of the fabric of this city. And this city then found a way to welcome them. That statue in Columbus Circle does not represent the explorer. It represents the experience of the Italian immigrant population who came here. And in a gift to the city of New York, Italian immigrants contributed to Il Progresso, which was then the newspaper. And they felt it was important enough to give back to the city that had given an opportunity to them, despite of all the obstacles. And that's what the Columbus Circle statue stands for, the experience of the Italian immigrants, not a particular individual in history. History has many complicated people. God knows we can talk about them all day. However, that statue means something to the people who contributed that gift to the city of New York. It meant that Italians had arrived, that we had finally overcome discrimination, and we were contributing back to the city that had given so much to us. And here we are today. We have the governor of the state of New York is an Italian American, the mayor of the city of New York is an Italian American, the controller of the state of New York is an Italian American. We have more Italian American elected officials in New York state government than any other ethnic group. We are captains of industry, we are in government, we are scholars, we are everywhere, as I said before. And we're simply asking people to respect the gift that we gave back to this city because it meant so much to us.
Thank you. Next, I want to call the minority leader of the city council, my colleague, Steven Matteo. Yay.
Thank you. Thank you for your leadership. Thank you all for being here and supporting us. You know, Diane talked about Italian American heritage and so passionately, and we're all in agreement with Diane. But we're also in agreement that we're starting down a very dangerous, slippery slope here. And Joe has mentioned it, and others have mentioned, you know, who's next? What's next? And it's a very subjective slippery slope. It's one, we shouldn't even be here having this conversation, as our historical statues are that. They're historical statues, the good, the bad, they're indifferent. We're supposed to learn from them. We're supposed to have that rational, respectful discussion on our history. And what we're doing here is we're going to be taking away and erasing our history. That's not what we're supposed to be doing. And on that end, should we then put a moratorium on all namings of buildings, of bridges, of ferries, street renamings? Should the council get out of the street renaming business? This is the slippery slope that this issue starts. And quite frankly, it's that simple. We shouldn't even be having this discussion. And the talk of unity around the world to stop those who have hate in their hearts, we all want to be unified against hate. But this issue is not unifying everybody. As much as we're unified here today, it is dividing people across not only the city, but but across this great nation, and it needs to stop. So I want to thank Councilman Borelli for his leadership. Thank you all for being here. Thank you.
It gets criticized, but I really want to thank all of you for coming today, because this is an issue that is a problem across our country of where we draw the line. And I want to just take a moment to acknowledge the fact that you guys have come out and made this such a significant issue for us as well. I want to next call up my successor in the State Assembly. It doesn't mean he's a bad guy, but he's my colleague and friend, Assemblyman Ron Castorina. Thank you. Thank you all for being here, and thank you, Joe and Steve, for your leadership on this issue. As Diane had indicated, this is not just a statue. It's not a statue to a man. It is a monument. It is a monument to, for, and by Italian-American immigrants. Italian-American immigrants that came to this country with nothing. Italian-American immigrants that came to this country with nothing but pride and the ability to conduct hard work, sacrifice, family values, and to contribute to this nation because they wanted a slice of the American dream. Those Italian-Americans didn't have the most easy time when they first got here to New York. They couldn't find jobs. In fact, there were people in leadership that denigrated them, that made it more difficult for them to get work. But they persevered. They didn't complain. They persevered. They became part of the American way. They took the American dream. They participated in what it means to be an American. And all the while, they were humble. They were humble, and they wanted to give back. They wanted to give back to the very nation that they had come to, that they were struggling in. And they gave back in the form of getting all of their money together under the guise of Il Progresso with the newspaper, and coming up with the funds to construct this amazing monument where 70 feet tall stands the icon of Italian-American culture. The icon of Italian-American culture, why? Because of some of the revisionist history that you hear? No. Because he was the first European explorer to come this way, to chart this course, yeah, to defy the science of his day. And the Italian Americans have always held him in a place of honor. 27 million Italian Americans strong, to this day we still hold him in a place of honor. We will continue to do so, and we will continue to fight to make sure that Columbus Circle remains Columbus Circle. The next speaker I want to bring up is the Deputy Majority Leader of the City Council, representing Brooklyn, Councilman Vincent Gentile.
Thank you. I know we have a lot of Italian Americans from across the five boroughs here today. I just want to know from a shout out, how many Brooklyn Italians do we have here today? All right, that's good, that's great, that's good. Well, if you look at Columbus, by who he is in his historical context, he's an explorer who discovered the New World and in so doing changed the course of history. And that achievement is remarkable given the time of his discovery. Think about it. Think about it, how he had to sail and survive harsh elements and navigate without the sophisticated technology that we have today is really a marvel that he discovered the New World. Just sailing around the globe at that time was a feat that others thought was impossible beyond the horizon. And so that is credited to Columbus. And yes, were there dangers along the way? Yes, there were. There were Native Americans that were not welcoming to him. So that he had to be not only an explorer, but a warrior too. And so we understand that. So if you put it in this historical context and not judge Columbus by the technology or the standards of today, but for the time he lived and the time he sailed, his discovery is quite remarkable. And that's why we Italian Americans and all Americans honor him today. It's why we Italian Americans revere Columbus. It's why the statue of Columbus stands proudly in New York today. And it's why we Italian Americans say, basta, enough is enough. The statue stays where it is.
want to introduce the councilman from Brooklyn, New York, Mark Treyger.
I want to thank my colleague, Councilman Borelli, for really organizing this so quickly, so effectively, and all my colleagues and advocates here. The context of Columbus Circle is really important. Let's get this clear. In 1891, 11 Italian Americans were lynched in New Orleans. They were lynched. And the president at that time, Roosevelt, called it a rather good thing. The New York Times said that rattlesnakes, street cuts, and murderers are better than Italian Americans. During that time. And the following, during that course of that year, as we heard from other speakers, one of the largest, if not the largest, Italian newspaper here in New York organized a grassroots campaign where they collected small dollar contributions, which we hear a lot about these days, where people who didn't have much means to themselves, as we heard the story of the Italian immigrants, they came here with nothing, very little means, but they donated and contributed to make sure that their history, their heritage, their culture, and what they've done for New York gets counted and matters too. Yeah. That's how Columbus Statue, the circle, was put together. So again, you had human rights violations occurring here in America. Our own president at the time calling it a good thing. Major publications praising the act. And ordinary immigrants working together, organizing a grassroots effort to say that our history, our heritage, our contributions matter too. Let's not lose sight of that. And let's also not lose sight of the fact that a number of Italian Americans and Italians have contributed not just to America, but to the world. And so I am proud to say that the Italian community has really helped shape New York, helped shape America, helped shape the world. And I want to say I'm thankful. I'm not Italian, but I'm grateful, and I thank the Italian community for their contributions to this world. And I'm going to close by saying, Forza Italia!